All right, so Keg Tap followers, November 1st, starting to get a little chilly outside, and so today we're going to be making a robust porter. It's actually a clone from Edmund Fitzgerald from Great Lakes Brewing Company, located in Cleveland, Ohio. If you don't know, Edmund Fitzgerald is actually the beer that got me into the craft beer scene, and so a special place in my heart for that beer. And today we're going to be go ahead and doing an all-grain batch of Edmund Fitzgerald. Right, so it is time to get brewing. I am heating up my strike water, which is the water that I will be adding to the grain to start the mash. I'm looking for roughly about 168 degree water for a resting mash temperature of 154. Okay, so I'm doughing in right now, which is essentially the term that is used to describe when you are adding your initial strike water to your grains. So give it a good stir, try not to splash too much, make sure to break up any dough balls. Now it is mash time. So I was looking for a temperature of 154 degrees. Go ahead and give it a little bit of a stir if you overshoot, and it will bring it back down to a desired temperature. We're going to be mashing for 60 minutes with this one. And now I'm heating up the sparge water. By sparging, I am essentially rinsing the grain bed of any remaining fermentable sugars. And so, bringing it up to about 190 degrees to get the grain bed up to 170. It's important not to exceed 170, as you risk the chance of extracting unwanted tannins and astringency. Now I'm collecting my first runnings. The mash went ahead and sat for 60 minutes, and so I'm now feeding the wort into the boil kettle, and we'll start the sparge as soon as all the liquid is drained. Now that I've collected my first runnings, I'm actually sparging now, so getting the grain bed up to roughly about 169 to 170 degrees. I'm going to go ahead and stir this up really good, let it sit for about 5 to 10 minutes, and then go ahead and boil off and then run off into the boil kettle. One of my brew day rituals is actually to turn on my Salina station. And so Salina helps me get through the rest of the brew day. And so I would encourage everybody out there to go ahead and find your favorite Spanish radio station or artist and go ahead and turn it up. With Salina in the background playing, as you can see, I got the wort up to a boil. I went ahead and already added my 60 minute addition of hops, and so that was 1 ounce of Centennial, one of my absolute favorites. A good rolling boil is absolutely critical to drive off any of the DMS along with concentrate the wort, and so we're going to be boiling for 60 minutes. Alright, so we have 10 minutes left of the boil. Went ahead and added my immersion chiller to ensure that it is well sanitized. At this point, you're going to want to ensure that everything that you are transferring the wort into is well sanitized to ensure that no bacteria or infection occurs. So we're going to go ahead and add the 10 minute additions and then finish out the rest of the boil. Alright, so now we are flowing into a well-sanitized carboy. It is down to yeast pitching temperatures, and so at this point, go ahead and flow into your fermentation vessel. Obviously, a brew day is not complete without a little help. Here's my wonderful daughter who absolutely loves to watch the sanitizer bubbles come out the top. Go ahead and give it a good shake for a couple minutes, pitch the yeast, and ferment, and you have beer.